I would say the biggest thing about biomedical engineering, as opposed to any engineering, is that with biomedical, not only do you have the math and physics, but you also have the science end of it, so you have chemistry, biology. So if you like the idea of applying the math, physics, chemistry, and biology to the human body, muscles, joints, cells, if that sounds interesting to you, I would definitely consider biomedical engineering.
I think biomedical engineering is great because it teaches the fundamentals of many different types of sciences. Instead of becoming extremely specific in a certain aspect of something, you become very knowledgeable on a lot of different topics. And that can allow you to be a great asset in multidisciplinary teams, and it can allow you to understand and have an understanding of the world in many different aspects.
What we really do is we solve very, very complex problems that require a lot of assumptions, and we have to feel comfortable with them, and we break them down to the simplest forms and we solve them.
The biggest issue that I've seen through the BME department when people come in here at first is that they just think biomedical engineering, it sounds cool, but they don't really analyze what the two biggest aspects that you're looking at, which are medical problems with the body and engineering and physics is within it as well. Like taking not only just like the muscles of the arm, but learning what those muscles are and then the physics behind them as well.
I picked biomedical engineering because you get to solve problems that really directly affect people, like someone that doesn't have an arm that wants a prosthetic arm, or someone that like can't have a specific surgery because we don't have the technology for it. It like personally affects their life rather than just, oh, like here's a new phone or here's like something to make your life a little bit easier.
Based on some of my co-op experiences, it can be anywhere from designing a prototype CAD to running laboratory experiments to the pharmaceutical industry to tissue development to even more of the mechanical side. I really think biomedical engineers are really broad in the fact that they can go out and solve problems in all of the different medical areas.
I think the best way to go about solving problems is to think about how you would want it to look in the future. So anytime you evaluate something, think about it from a futuristic perspective and say, what is the best way that this could look at the end? And if you can visualize that, you can work toward that.
First, you have to understand how the body works, because that's like either the, well, in my opinion, it's usually the starting point and the ending point. And then your job is to fill it in between.
Well, initially, I was kind of torn between mechanical with a bioengineering option and biomedical engineering. And I decided to go biomedical engineering because I figured I'd rather learn how the body works. So if I were to make something for the human body, I'd rather be more knowledgeable about the environment it's going into or interacting with, which is the human body.
They solve problems. They start at the beginning and they see this is what we want to do. This is what we want to change. This is the problem we want to solve.
And figuring out different ways to access the component of the pancreas that's the problem. Because a big old surgical whack to get to the pancreas is a lot like that surgery we talked about trying to get to the pituitary in the head.
RIT incorporates a great blend of co-ops, laboratory experience, as well as classroom experience, and that gives you hands-on experience working with concepts that you first learn in the classroom and then can apply into the laboratory and practice and gain a skill set that is useful on co-op and useful out in the real world and industry.
Between classroom and lab, typically my classes go along with a lab, so whatever we learned in class that week or the week prior was applied in laboratory. And that was valuable because you get some hands-on experience and you can kind of, instead of working with just the equations on a piece of paper, you can go in and see the actual devices and tools used and get an idea of why you learned all those equations.
Nate is gonna go ahead and look over to 3.2 and the program will measure the voltage change. Then he'll look back and we'll see what happens. Possibly it could be used to diagnose different types of seizures, whether they're physiological or induced.
Can can also use it to measure your reaction time to something. So if someone's like having difficulty like picking up like a light turning color, possibly concussion testing or something like that.
Well, it's when you take the theory
and apply it. So it's more than just taking it from the textbook, from the teacher's mouth, from the PowerPoint, your notes in the classroom, and really putting it in your own hands and seeing it for yourself and seeing it qualitatively and quantitatively through analysis and whatnot, and seeing what worked, what didn't, and why, and then seeing how theory and practice are different, because as you do lab work and research, you'll realize that there are discrepancies between theories. What actually happens?
Yeah, we're doing a diffusion experiment. So this is the dialysis membrane, and so it's modeling like a cell membrane, and it has pores in it. So we're going to use this as our cellular fluid, and then we're going to be putting in this iodine solution as our extracellular fluid, and we're going to be seeing what diffuses across the membrane, and then a reaction will occur, and it will change color.
We're basically working on an experiment to show different kinds of diffusion. So basically we're going to have two different setups and basically compare and contrast the diffusion styles that are used in each.
First of all, I had never seen the dialysis membrane before, and that's what is used to purify blood. And I like this because we're learning about diffusion through the cell, using like a product that is out there that is used as a medical device.
My lab's kind of taught me like what is a official industry standard way to make a report for something like submitting to the FDA or some other regulatory agency.
I used a lot of the things I learned in my cell molecular bio lab while on co-op, like aseptic technique and cell culture. So having those skills already was definitely an asset to starting on the right foot for co-op.
So I actually think some of the laboratory settings was how I got one of my co-ops. So for Johnson & Johnson, I talked to them about all my cell culture experience, and because of that, I really think that's how I got placed on the product development side.
Like, co-op was a graduation requirement, so I knew I was going to be co-oping before I graduated. If you go anywhere else that doesn't have that co-op experience, you're just doing the same thing, except you have all these added loans onto. Because a lot of different companies like ask for like that professional experience right away, even for a starting position. So just having that on your belt already just helps out astronomically.
One of the things I was working on at co-op was figuring out what kind of excipients go in a drug product to make the protein stable for manufacturing and for shipment and for storage, and then eventually when they enter the body. And so I got a lot of experience with proteins and the different ways they fold. So one of the things we're doing for our senior design project is building a protein spectrometer that measures protein folding and is small enough and robust enough to fit within inside a CubeSat, which is a miniaturized satellite, so we can study protein in low Earth orbit under the effects of microgravity.
I've been doing research with the building next door. I was essentially the electrical engineer in designing circuitry and breadboard design. What I liked about it was I got a chance to be a different type of engineer, but also at the same time I understand what's going on, and I'm also a part of the analysis and discussion portion. I mean, there is cell culture that goes on in that lab, which we've learned, but I'm more so, my primary role is more for the statistical analysis and decision of where our research will go.
In my last co-op, I was really exposed to the whole concept to launch a product process, which has really helped me with senior design, knowing that when you go from the concept development to the product development stage, and then from there, the steps you take to do testing and mitigate risks to then go to launching your product has been really replicable in senior design now.
This program especially is small enough that you have the resources, the teachers are there, professors are there to talk to you, really get to know everybody. One thing I would do is check your email, and there's a lot of biomedical engineering, there's a society, resume reviews, things like that. I checked my email, I got something about research, emailed the professor, met up, and ended up doing research all summer of my right after my first year, so that was really great. But really just take advantage of all the opportunities that there are and see where it takes you.
I guess keep your inspiration, or just keep an interest, whether it's YouTube videos, TED Talks, or like, you know, I follow research groups just because I like what they do, and it's a variety of things that they do, so just see like the application of what I'm learning, what I've learned, and what I will learn, and how all those are needed to achieve the goals that they're completing. It's just nice to see that if once you do make those connections, that you realize that they're, you know, almost like a higher purpose per se.
So in my case, I've had two co-ops in the pharmaceutical industry, and I've been able to see the real world impact that my education can have. And having a great education allows you to add value into industry, and adding value into industry, especially something like a pharmaceutical company, can have a direct impact on patients and improve their lives.
It's kind of the future. It's evolving. There's always a job for a biomedical engineer. There's always a really cool new way to optimize a procedure or a device. And I mean, overall, the classwork is tough. There's no question about it, but it's really interesting stuff. You want to study it.
There's a fundamental good in making things better. And I always think about biomedical engineering kind of like the Olympic motto, which is faster, stronger, higher. And I think that everyone should have the ability to run, play, swim, jump, and really get to enjoy the things that a normal human being should enjoy. So that's why I chose biomedical engineering.
BME is the best major ever.
Well, that's what the acronym stands for.
Okay.